all the men, on that whole idea of thug, and we defy that whole meaning, that mentality of what a child might believe that to be, and then we model for them manhood, and as a community school, we understand that we're not good at everything. We do some things very well, but having the opportunity of the community school to bring in experts who do things very well at no charge. Wally Shabazz has been with me working with our young men since I stepped foot on this campus. Overnight, looking at the souls of children transform, looking at a school that children did not have a vision or direction of who they were. Working with Rishi Butler, you feel the spirit that he presents. He mesmerized our children. And he gives them a different picture, a different image, and a sense of hope, and we transition that despair. We speak their language. We confirm their existence. We're consistent with them. And it's not just about the instruction up front. It's about tapping into the souls of our children. So Jenny, when you speak about core values, that's been the transformation of Middleton High School. It hasn't been a charade, it hasn't been, it's been love. And it's not that idea of love that, it's that all emotional love. We kick that behind if we have to kick that behind. But at the same time, we hug them when we need to hug them. And we pierce through that idea, that shell of thugism. Because at the core, they're beautiful children and they're brilliant children. And Middleton is just getting started. And I want to just take this opportunity, because I know there's a lot of people on this panel, to thank the organizations. From TPD, I have a police officer, PC Davis. He's an instructional leader here. He breaks down the barriers of the conflict between the police and our children. He couldn't be here, wouldn't be here if he didn't love kids. So, Jenny, I think your question is right on point. I think that we have to begin. I think Middleton will be a model for this country, both on the STEM and on the traditional side. Because our traditional kids, they can kick butt also. Our robotics team, number one in the world. We beat Japan, China, Australia, Canada, and I could go down the list. And I'll close with this. Building this community, Middleton has an open door policy. And that doesn't mean we can house every organization, but we can share with you some of the ills. And if you have an expertise with that ill, it may not be in the schoolhouse, but if it's somewhere in the community that impacts children, that impact Middleton, we could use your support and your work.
Thank you. As we speak, I want to remind you to think of a question. But I want to say this. I want to make it clear that there is not a discord here. We know that there are many ways to reduce crime in our community. Many people are doing many different things. This was not one entity that created the problem in our community. It will not be one entity to solve the problem. That's why I'm glad I didn't hear somebody say the only way. I want to acknowledge Mr. Norman Campbell, who is the former Chief Probation Officer of the Department of Juvenile Justice. Give him a round of applause. Let me say this. For 26 years, we've been taking those young people and we fought. Now we have a civil citation program. It's okay if somebody else wants to take the credit for it. But we believe that our kids should not be penalized the first time. We wanted to give them behavior modification training and education.